NASA says Starliner is ready to come back to Earth. The Boeing spacecraft will undock from the International Space Station on Friday and try to land in White Sands, New Mexico.
Today, officials stressed the ISS will stay safe even if Starliner's thrusters stop working altogether.
You know, many parts of the flight went extremely well.
NASA is praising Starliner as a good spacecraft, but in the end, unanswered questions over helium leaks and thruster malfunctions were too great a risk to bring Commander Butch Wilmore and pilot Sonny Williams home. Starliner is now ready to undock. The flight director of the ISS is confident there is zero risk to the station, even if all Starliner's thrusters stop firing.
There are springs that are currently charged up and ready to go on the Starliner side of the docking port. And so as soon as the hooks release and allow the vehicles to have motion, those springs are going to push Starliner away from ISS.
The manager of the commercial crew program, Steve Stitch, says there will be many changes needed before the next crewed mission.
Obviously, we have a number of helium leaks. We think these are related to a seal in the thruster flange itself. That seal, when it's exposed to oxidizer, which is the vapor from the propellant, one of the oxidizer propellants, we think that maybe it's causing a little degradation in that seal. So one of the things we're looking at is a different material on the seal.
Stitch says Boeing will have to redesign the thrusters to prevent them from overheating, causing the spaceship to lose mobility.
Clearly, the way we fire the thrusters causes the thruster to overheat and causes this poppet on the Teflon poppet on the oxide to swell. And so we need to go understand what kinds of pulses in particular cause that swelling.
Starliner will take less than 8 hours to plop down in the New Mexico desert. NASA hopes a new crew test flight might blast off this time next year.
NASA says Butch and Sonny are remaining busy up on the ISS. The two veteran astronauts have done more than 40 science experiments and more than 100 hours of research. The Crew 8 Dragon will now be configured with 6 seats in case of emergency with the Starliner coming down to Earth. Crew 9 will launch from the Kennedy Space Center later this month with 2 people on board, then 4 come back next February.